Welcome to my classroom. I am Nesli. In this video, I shall try to explain two important sentences. The first sentence says that Nernst potential is not a true electrical potential difference. The second sentence says that the ions try to equalize their Nernst potential to the membrane potential. So let us start. We know that all cells in our body have an electrical potential difference between the two sides of the cell membrane. In this electrical potential difference, the interior of the cell close to the cell membrane carries more negative charges compared to the outside. So this electrical potential difference that is present at rest in all of the cells in our body is called a resting membrane potential. Not all cells, but some cells in our body, muscle cells, heart cells, nerve cells, and secretory cells of the pancreas, are able to change the resting membrane potential and produce two more types of electrical potential differences across the cell membrane. These are local potentials and action potentials. So these three potentials, resting membrane potential, local, and action potentials, they are membrane potentials. Why do we call them membrane potentials but not cell potentials? Because this electrical potential difference, these three membrane potentials, are confined to a very small area in the neighborhood of the cell membrane. The rest of the cell and the extracellular fluid, or the rest of the intracellular and extracellular fluid, are electrically neutral. So Nernst potential, on the other hand, may carry the word potential in its name, but it is not a true electrical potential difference. Then, what is the Nernst potential? Let us try to explain this. For the ions must cross the cell membrane from one side to the other to produce the three electrical potentials, or to maintain them, maintain the membrane potentials. For the ions to cross the membrane, two conditions are required. What are they? One is an open ion channel that lets the passage of that specific ion. The second requirement is that there must be a driving force that is going to push that ion through the ion channel. The driving force can be of two types, electrical or chemical. The electrical force is the membrane potential that is present at the membrane at the time that the channels are open. It can be one of the membrane potentials that I talked about. It can be the resting membrane potential, it can be the local potential, or it can be during the action potential. So these membrane potentials represent the electrical force. On the other hand, Nernst potential is representing the chemical force that is produced by the concentration difference of an ion in the extracellular and the intracellular fluids. How do we use them? I have explained this in the video, how to use the Nernst potential. We use the membrane potential and the Nernst potential to calculate the net electrochemical force. And when we find the net electrochemical force, the direction of it is going to tell us the direction of the ion movement that is going to take place. What is the importance of the Nernst potential for the ions? The ions try to equalize the Nernst potential and the electrical potential, the membrane potential. Nernst potential, when this happens, we reach the Nernst potential and the ions reach an equilibrium. At this equilibrium, Nernst potential, the force of it, is equal to the potential of the membrane, the force of the membrane potential. They are in opposite directions, and the electrochemical force, the net driving force, is zero. There will be, in a condition like this, there will be no ion movement or ion current. Then we say that the ion has reached an equilibrium. So the other name of the Nernst potential is actually equilibrium potential. Let us try to explain this by taking the example of potassium and giving some numbers. So here I have drawn two cells. Both of these cells have the same Nernst potential, the chemical force for potassium. It is minus 80 millivolt. We know that the chemical force for potassium must push potassium out of the cell, like I have placed the black arrows here, because potassium is in high concentration inside the cell and in low concentration outside the cell. So Nernst potential is 80 millivolts. The size or the amplitude of this chemical force is 80 millivolts pushing potassium outward in both of the cells. What is the difference of these cells? The cell on the left side, according to your position, has a membrane potential minus 85 millivolts. What does this mean? The negative sign here tells us that inside the cell membrane has more negative charges. Potassium has a positive charge, so this force, the electrical force, should be pulling the potassium ion into the cell, and I have shown this with a red arrow. So we see here that the size of our red arrow is 85 millivolts, while the chemical force is only 80 millivolts. So what is the result? The electrochemical net driving force. We see that by 5 millivolts of net force, potassium is pushed into the cell. So, what is going to happen when potassium enters the cell under the effect of this net driving force? Potassium has positive charges. When it enters the cell, it is going to neutralize some of the negativity inside the cell. So, when negativity decreases, the cell's membrane potential will move towards the Nernst potential of potassium. Let's have a look at the other cell. The cell on the right side, according to your position, has a membrane potential of minus 70 millivolt. Now let us compare the electrical and chemical forces here. The chemical forces here in the cell is the same. It is 80 millivolts. On the other hand, membrane potential, that is pulling potassium into the cell, is 75 millivolts. This time the size of the chemical force is bigger than the size of the electrical force. So the difference between the two is going to give us the net electrochemical force, and we can say that it is in the outward direction. So we have a force pushing potassium out of the cell, and if there are open potassium channels, potassium will move out of the cell. Potassium carries a positive charge, so when positive charges move out, negative charges are going to be left behind, and this is going to increase the negativity in the cell. When the negativity inside the cell increases, this membrane potential will start moving from minus 75 towards minus 80 millivolt, which is the Nernst potential of potassium. When the membrane potential becomes equal to the Nernst potential, the ions will be at equilibrium and ion flow, ion current, is going to stop. So in this video, I tried to explain two important sentences. One is that Nernst potential is not a true electrical potential difference. It represents the chemical force. Two, the second sentence was that the ions try to bring the membrane potential towards the Nernst potential. You see that under different conditions, the ions move in such a direction that they try to equalize these two potentials. I hope this information has been useful for you. Thank you for watching.